these things. First, toxins. Now, we all know that toxins is, in Tagalog, is lason. Anything that is in excess in our body is called toxins. This may come from excessive eating or even the chemicals in the food that we eat, such as the preservatives, the colorings, and others. Now, and toxins is not only limited to food. We have pollution and other things that are contributes to the toxin accumulation in our body. Then there's also the free radicals. Free radicals are molecules that contribute to many different diseases. They are created when our body breaks down food or through pollution and radiation. The damage caused by the free radicals can result in a wide range of illnesses and chronic diseases, including cancer. So free radicals are usually part of the things that yung ating kinakain, and these are sometimes unavoidable part of the food that we eat. Then another problem is stress. Maybe I don't need to stress about stress anymore. I'm sure alam natin lahat kung ano nangyayari sa katawan natin when we are stressed. Our body secretes hormones like cortisol that in abundance can be fatal to us. So ang stress ay talagang napakalaking, it's a very big problem if we really put our minds into stress. Next is modern lifestyle. The normal function of our system is disrupted because of our normal lifestyle. Sleeping habits, eating habits are all different because of the modern lifestyle that we have right now. Another problem is the eating habit. Eating too much, too little, too fast, or not even on time. No? Naiiba-iba yung habit ng pagkain. That's why the body has a hard time adjusting to it, causing eventually digestive problems. Then there's malnutrition. Malnutrition means lack of proper nutrition. It can be caused by not having enough to eat, not eating enough of the right food, or being unable to use the food that one does eat. So, ibig sabihin, pwede yung kinakain natin walang sustansya, or pwede kokoonte yung kinakain natin na may sustansya, hindi natin nakakain yung tamang pagkain, or tama man yung pagkain na ini-intake natin, but the problem is the body cannot process it anymore. The body cannot use the nutrients it gets from the food. Now, then there's also the no money, no time syndrome. Sometimes we already know what is wrong with us, but we always use this excuse to not do something about it. Now, minsan nararamdaman na natin yung problema sa katawan natin, and yet we turn a blind eye because we don't have time, we don't have money. So yan yung laging problema, no? And of course, DXN helps to provide the best support. So part of the solution is the DXN products. DXN products are supplements, meaning it is an additional from the usual or what we are supposed to be eating. Now, so to summarize, the body consists of bundles of cells. The body is like a car. It needs maintenance. The body is exposed to different tortures that sometimes is self-inflicted. The body is fighting against the garbage within. It's so sad that sometimes the body is already losing the battle. The body cannot talk to us verbally, but it could send signs through the symptoms and manifestations na na-experience na ating katawan that there is something wrong with us. And the most important thing is the body needs support. And very luckily, we have DXN products to provide the best support that we need. All right. So let's discuss a little bit about nutrition. We said a while ago that cells in the body needs nutrition. So what are the different kinds of nutrition that we need? There are two types of nutrition. There's the macronutrition and the micronutrition. Macronutrients are the proteins, the fat, carbohydrates, fibers, and water. Basically, this is the food pyramid. So ito yung mga majority ng ating kinakain. Doon natin nakukuha yung protein, yung fat, yung carbohydrates, fiber, and water, which is very, very important. Macronutrients are the energy-carrying nutrient. The body also needs micronutrients. These are the vitamins and minerals, trace elements, enzymes, phytonutrients, and chlorophyll that are also needed by the body. It enables the cells to extract energy from micronutrients. Both cannot do without each other. So if we could provide the protein, the fat, the carb, the macronutrients in our body, we also need the micronutrients. That's supposed to be, we could also get it from the food that we eat. Now that we know that what our bodies go through, what it needs to maintain a healthy body, let me introduce to you the main star of DXN, which is Ganoderma lucidum, the red mushroom that provides both macro and micronutrients to our cells. Ganoderma lucidum, as we all know, gano means bright, derma means skin, lucidum means shiny. It's also known as the king of herbs, the elixir of immortality, the herb of spiritual potency, the herb of deathlessness, and the soup of the emperor with 1,000 mistresses. Now, it has a lot of name, but the best name given to Ganoderma is it being the king of herbs. Maraming queen. Maraming nagkiklaim na sila yung queen. But there's only one king, and that is Ganoderma lucidum. It contains more than 400 elements with polysaccharides, organic germanium, adenosine, triterpenoids, ganoderic essence as its major elements. Ganoderma has been used in traditional Asian medicine for thousands of years, providing both nutritive and health benefits to the human body. It may have beneficial effects on the immune system, cardiovascular system, and the reproductive system, and may help treat a variety of conditions. So let's go to our first product. We have the Reshi Gano, or the RG. This is the Ganoderma lucidum that is harvested from a 90-day-old red mushroom. So pinalilipas muna yung 90-day-old, kaya lagi namin sinasabi, ito yung matandang Ganoderma. Okay? So 90-day-old. Anong meron sa 90-day-old na Ganoderma? It is rich in triterpenoids, adenosine, and polysaccharides. Now I'll just go through a little bit of definition. Kung ano ba yung polysaccharide, adenosine, and triterpenoids. Polysaccharides is the cleanser and detoxifier. It is a carbohydrate that exhibits anti-tumor, anti-mutagenic, anti-coagulant, anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial, and antiviral. Triterpenes is the builder, or yung triterpenoids. It is the bitter taste in the RG. It is a very powerful antioxidant. An antioxidant is a substance that removes potentially damaging oxidizing agents in a living organism. It prevents or slows down damage to cell caused by the free radicals. So ito yung kalaban ni free radicals, yung antioxidant. That's why our body should be given a lot of antioxidant to fight the free radicals in our body. We also have the adenosine. Adenosine is the regulator. It regulates the body's hormone functions, boosts energy level, and fights off stress. It exerts a calming and sedative effect in the body. So overall, RG is for detoxification. It improves blood circulation and our metabolism. So si RG, siya po yung tagalinis, tagatanggal ng mga inipon nating toxins sa katawan. Okay, that's the work of the RG. Ang kapartner po ni RG ay si Ganocelium, or we fondly called GL. Coming from the same plant, this is same Ganoderma lucidum, this is a 14-day-old mycelium. Okay? This is the reproductive element of the fungi, which can then form into a fruiting body of a mushroom. In other words, ito lang po yung bubot. Ito pa lang yung patubo. Okay? So 14 days old, and then it is harvested already. So what do we get from a 14-day-old Ganoderma lucidum? GL is potent with organic germanium, ganoderic essence, polysaccharides, and a spectrum of vitamins and minerals. What is an organic germanium? Organic germanium is a powerful antioxidant. It is a substance that helps strengthen the bones and the immune system, improves oxygen supply to the brain, reduces cholesterol levels and blood pressure, stabilizes blood sugar, and improves the heart and the liver functions. If based on what Dr. Lim was telling us many years ago, the organic germanium content of Ganoderma is when it is compared to garlic, is 69 times more potent. So, ganun kadami yung antioxidant ni organic germanium sa Ganoderma. Ganoderic essence keeps the skin healthy. So ito yung nagko-contribute para tayo ay magmukhang bata. Overall, GL is the balancer. It improves blood circulation to the brain and regenerates the body's cells and organ. It is best when they are both used together, RG and GL, because they are really partners. Kasi sabi nga namin, they are husband and wives na hindi dapat pinaghihiwalay. While the Ganoderm, while the RG is cleansing, GL is already repairing and balancing. Though they work hand in hand together. Now, we always hear the word adaptogen. Okay, what is an adaptogen? Adaptogenic food is anything that is natural and that even for a long use will not give any adverse effect on the skin. So it's on the body, I'm sorry. So ibig sabihin hindi ma-over. According to Dr. Hans Selye, who is a Nobel Prize winner, he is known as the father of stress, meaning hindi po siya yung stress, no? Meaning he is known for his studies of the effect of stress on the human body. So siya yung nag-aral kung ano nangyayari sa katawan when our bodies is stressed. And according to Dr. Hans Selye, as an adaptogen, Ganoderma is non-toxic. It is not limited to special organs or tissues. And it has an overall normalizing effect. So coming from a third party again, it gives us an assurance that Ganoderma is a powerful adaptogen. So ladies and gentlemen, those are the positive features or characteristics of our Ganoderma. Now, maybe some would ask, what's the difference of a Ganoderma and a drug? Okay, or yung gamot. Okay, a drug is chemical, it's synthetic, so it's made from artificial ingredients, wherein Ganoderma is natural. No? Our RG and GL are all 100% pure in each capsule, no additive, no coloring, no preservative, walang ibang dinagdag, kundi 100% pure Ganoderma ang mai-enjoy ninyo. Sa drug, there's a possible side effect, or it could affect some of the other systems in your body, wherein Ganoderma is an ailment reflection. Sa drug, you expect a cure, or nagagaling ka pag uminom ka ng gamot na yon, wherein Ganoderma prevents the possibility na magkasakit ka. A drug is target specific, meaning if masakit ang ulo mo, ang kailangan mong inumin ay pang sakit ng ulo, wherein Ganoderma has an overall normalizing effect. Remember that Ganoderma works for in the system of our body. It's a system, works a system. So hindi siya nagiging specific, but it works sa buong katawan natin. It gives what our body needs. It detoxifies kung ano yung kailangan ng katawan natin and repairs where it is needed. Drug is for a disease, wherein Ganoderma is for body wellness. As much as possible, we start using Ganoderma, hindi dahil meron na tayong sakit, but because we wanted to maintain the wellness of our body. Drug is human technology. This is usually developed in a laboratory, wherein Ganoderma is a natural technology. Tumubo lang sa labas. Excuse me. A drug is a single molecule. Let's say, for example, a paracetamol is for a specific problem or a specific sickness, wherein Ganoderma contains more than 400 elements. No? Sa drug, may overdose. Sa Ganoderma, wala po tayong overdose because it's just the usage and consumption. Remember, Ganoderma is a food, so we could consume as much food as we want. Alright, so you can see the difference ng drug or ng gamot against sa Ganoderma. Kaya dito sa atin, hindi natin tinatanong kung ganito yung sakit ko, anong dapat inumin ko? Kasi may sakit or walang sakit, Ganoderma is the best thing. Now, what are the different theories that dapat nating maging familiar with so we could be more equipped on how to market our products? There's the acidic versus the alkaline theory. There's the enzyme theory, the green theory, and the what is good for your stomach is good for your face or skin theory. All right, isa-isahin natin sila para mas mahimay natin. Okay. The human body needs to eat alkaline food and acidic food in the ratio of 4:1. So, in simple terms, it has to be 80% alkaline, that is fruits, wheat, milk, algae, and vegetables. No? And only 20% should be acidic food. That's meat, soft drinks, processed foods, sugar, pork, alcohol, coffee, and black tea, etc. No? Unfortunately, modern eating habits is exactly what is happening. 20% po ng kinakain natin ay alkaline, 80% ang acidic. Or sometimes, halos walang alkaline food. So that's what's really sad, no? What happens to our body when it has excess acid or yung over-acidity? It's called acidosis. It can cause a variety of health problems and chronic diseases. That's why it's very important for us to try so hard na maging alkaline yung ating diet o mas mataas yung alkalinity ng ating kinakain compared sa acidity. Now, we always cannot eat fruits and vegetables. No? That's why we have DXN alkaline products. Yeah, like RGGL, spirulina, spikety, lingshi coffee, and morinchi. That could supply the alkaline that our body needs. No? Among all these products, I'll give focus first on the spikety because the other products we'll pass through later aside from the RGGL, which we have discussed earlier. Spikety is a herbal tea blended of 5 natural herbs that helps improve our respiratory system. It has a mucolytic action and it has that mint flavor that refreshes the body. So, itong mga produkto po na ito would give us the alkaline that our body needs if we cannot provide it with the natural food. Okay. Next, we have the enzyme theory. Diabetes is a very popular or common disease that affects a lot of people. We sometimes attribute it to genetics. But one big factor really is the food choices that we make. Diabetes is only the result. Diabetes is caused by a malfunction of the pancreas. It does not secrete enough insulin to process the sugar intake. And this is due to digestive problems. We experience digestive problems because of the food that we eat.